going out to. Come on. I'm going out tonight. I'm feeling alright. Gonna let it all hang out. Wanna make some noise. Really raise my voice. Yeah, I wanna scream and shout. No inhibitions, make no conditions. Get a little out of line. I ain't gonna act politically correct. I only wanna have a good time. The best thing about being a woman is the prerogative to have a little fun. Oh, 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 they're totally crazy. Forget I'm a lady. Men in shirt, short skirts. Oh, 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 really go wild. Even nerd in style. Oh, 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 get in the action. Feel the attraction. Cover my head, do what I dare. Oh, 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 wanna be free, yeah. Feel the way I feel. Man, I feel like a woman. Chance to get out on the town. We don't need romance, we only wanna dance. We're gonna lay our head down. The best thing about being a woman is the prerogative to have a little fun. Oh, 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 they're totally crazy. Forget I'm a lady. Men shirt, short skirts. Feel like a woman. Like a woman.
I've lost so many long nights. Felt words that cut like knives. I know they're gonna say what they wanna. And I know they're gonna say what they want. But I feel it changing. I can taste it. I'm on the wave and I won't waste it. I have been patient, but I'm not waiting anymore. Not anymore, no. Unbroken glass, and I'm gonna make that ceiling crash. That ceiling crash. So what? Still got knives in my back. So what? So I'm tied to the tracks. Yeah, I'm gonna dance on broken glass. Hey, here I go, here I go. Ooh, ooh. Yeah, here I go, here I go. Ooh, ooh. Hey, here I go, here I go. That ceiling crashed, so what? Still got knives in my back, so what? So I'm tied to the tracks, yeah. I'm gonna dance on broken glass. Hey, here I go, here I go.
Stronger, stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely.
my breath. Scared to rock the boat and make a mess. So I said quietly, agreed politely. I guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me past the breaking point. I stood for nothing, so I fell for everything. You held me down, but I got up, already brushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound, like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up, get ready cause I've had.
What would I do if I had more time?
Wow.
If I had more time, I'd call my grandma back. I miss her.
I'd go straight to the studio and dance my little heart out.
I would take up the guitar again because I have always wanted to be a rock star.
I would love to spend more time laughing.
I'd empower women to move.
I would do more of what I want to do and less of what I have to do.
If I had more time, I'd give it all to her.
If I had more time,
if I had more time,
if I had more time.
In 2008, at the age of 37, I suffered a heart attack, and I never saw it coming.
At 10, I was diagnosed with dilated cardiomyopathy, and at 22, I had a heart transplant.
Thanks to research funded by the American Heart Association,
so many of us have been given more time.
More time with our families, more time with our dreams, and more time to accomplish the things that cardiovascular disease tried to take from us.
And we're not going anywhere.
Welcome to the American Heart Association's 20th annual Go Red for Women campaign digital experience. I'm Tamsin Fidel from Pix 11 News and so happy to be emceeing today's event. Cardiovascular disease is the leading cause of death for women, taking one woman's life every 80 seconds. And it's on the rise, impacting younger generations of women out there. While nearly 80% of cardiac events can be prevented, one in three women will die from cardiovascular disease. That's approximately one woman every minute. One is too many. It's imperative we change this fact, yet disparities in care for women's heart health continue to exist. Cardiovascular disease is no longer just an elderly man's problem. It impacts women of all ages, races, ethnicities, and backgrounds. Yet women continue to be overlooked, symptoms dismissed, and significantly underrepresented in the life-saving research that is needed to treat, beat, and prevent heart disease and strokes. Our hope is that after today, you'll be ready to be an agent of change for women. Each individual voice strengthens our efforts because together there is nothing women cannot achieve. Today you won't see each other, just the presenters, videos, and the comments in our chat box. You can use the chat box to take part and make sure you're messaging the group by selecting the drop-down feature, all attendees and participants. Use the hashtag GoRedForWomen and hashtag GoRedLI and follow AHA New York on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I'd also like to remind you that you can view our virtual auction on any device, such as your phone or computer, and you can place your bid through the Go Red for Women website, longislandgoredluncheon.heart.org. Keep watching for those alerts on your mobile phones and computer. The link to the Go Red for Women auction is in the chat box now. Our auction closes tomorrow, March 25th at 12 p.m. Now it's my pleasure to introduce our first guest. She's known as Daytime TV's leading lady. All my children fans know her as Erica Kane. Please welcome the one and only Susan Lucci.
Hi, I'm Susan Lucci. I'm the National Ambassador for the American Heart Association's Go Red for Women movement. And I am so happy to welcome you to today's Go Red for Women virtual luncheon. I'm sure that all of us can agree that this pandemic has just turned all of our lives upside down. And I think that's why it's more important than ever that we stay connected this way. We stay connected, especially with so many of us struggling with isolation and social distancing. And more important than ever to have these important conversations about heart disease and stroke, especially in light of the fact that science is now revealing that there is a connection between heart disease and COVID-19. I am so happy to share my story with so many of you who are my sister survivors. In 2018, I had a heart episode of my own, one that changed my life forever. In my case, I had experienced a couple of very light symptoms that I was able to talk myself out of, that I explained away in my head as being nothing. So many of us women, we say, oh, it's nothing. That's what I did. But the third time I experienced the symptoms, they were symptoms that I could not ignore. I felt literally like an elephant was pressing on my chest. Well, I was so lucky. I was surrounded by people that day at that time, people who could act quickly, who got me to the hospital, and the best doctor in the whole world saved my life. I am so happy to be here with you today, along with my two stents. Mostly, what I want to really emphasize is the importance for you to listen to your symptoms, to know what the signs are and to act on them. So many of us as women, we put ourselves way at the bottom of our list, our to-do list. But when it comes to your health, I want you to put yourself first. I am so happy that you're here today. I am so happy that we are connecting this way. And most of all, this virtual luncheon is supposed to be fun. So there are going to be some great speakers. You will hear them speak on a variety of topics. And one of the best things about a virtual luncheon is that you can go red any way you like, even in red PJs. Today I am coming to you from the sun porch in our home on Long Island, outside of New York City. And I decided that I would get a little dressed up. I have on a red dress and some jewelry. And actually this is the first time I've had real clothes on in about 3 weeks here in New York. And it feels good. I just wanted to get dressed up for the luncheon. I just hope you have a wonderful time today. No matter how you choose to go red for today's luncheon, I am so thrilled that you've decided to go red with us.
She is the best. Thanks so much, Susan, for all your support of Women's Health and the Go Red for Women campaign. As Susan mentioned, reports are showing that those who have heart disease or survived a stroke may be more vulnerable to COVID-19, with a mortality rate of 2 to 3 times higher than the general population. Please take a minute to write in the chat box names of friends and family who are on the front lines of COVID-19 response. Remember, you have to select all attendees and participants before you can start typing in the chat box. So many of the first responders I see you mentioning are women. Together, of course, we can make the largest impact on our Long Island community and save more lives. So I'd like to take this time to thank our amazing sponsors, the National Go Red for Women sponsor, CVS Health, our local Life is Why sponsors, Mount Sinai, South Nassau, and Petro Home, Northwell Health, Jaspin Schlesinger LLP, Vox International Co., swag bag sponsor, and remember, you could purchase a Go Red for Women swag bag for $150. Flushing Bank, NYU Langone Health, Capital One Bank, Dime Bank, Ace Family Foundation, BDO, City National Bank, Ernst & Young, KPMG, Louis J. Akampora Foundation, Morad Hawk and Hamroff LLP, NYCB Foundation, Signature Bank, Sterling National Bank, Pix11 Media Sponsor. Your support is so important and so appreciated, especially during this difficult time. We also want to recognize the woman that led the charge for Go Red over the last year. Her strength, compassion, guidance, and strategic thinking have resulted in a successful campaign. We're grateful for her incredible leadership. Please welcome our 2021 chair of the Long Island Go Red for Women campaign, Jyothi Narendran. She is a co-managing partner of the Garden City firm, Jaspin Schlesinger LLP.
Hello, I'm Jyothi Narendran, the co-managing partner at Jaspin Schlesinger LLP and the chair of Go Red for Women on Long Island. I'm also a member of the American Heart Association Long Island Board of Directors. I'm proud to have led this year's Long Island Go Red for Women campaign. I want to thank you all for taking the time to joining us in support of the American Heart Association for today's Go Red for Women digital experience. This year's Go Red for Women campaign builds on all the great work we have done to help our mothers, daughters, friends, and other loved ones understand the symptoms of heart disease and to take control of their heart health. As you saw in the opening video, heart disease and stroke have never just been men's diseases, but through the years, women have been left out of important research studies. Women have been underrepresented, uncounted, undiagnosed, and untreated. Now we're advocating for better representation in medical research, pushing for equitable access to care and treatments for all. That is what drew me personally to the Go Red for Women movement. The American Heart Association provides education and awareness about heart disease and stroke to our community, and we work tirelessly to improve lives and promote prevention and health equity. I'd like to thank our Go Red for Women executive leadership team and the Go Red for Women auction and passion committees. We value your incredible leadership and support of the Go Red for Women campaign. I would like to acknowledge the honorees, Anthony D'Alessio, and the medical honoree, Mount Sinai South Nassau. There are two other groups I'd like to acknowledge, Circle of Red and Corps Vitae. Circle of Red are ambassadors who personally make an annual financial commitment to the Go Red for Women movement at the $1,000 level or above. Anyone who makes a personal annual investment of $5,000 or more is recognized in our National Philanthropic Giving Society, Corps Vitae. All of your personal gifts provide much needed financial support to continue the vital work of the American Heart Association. Working together, we are spreading life-saving information to our friends, family, and neighbors, and joining forces to overcome the statistic that cardiovascular disease is the number one killer of women. Go Red for Women is one of the many vehicles the American Heart Association harnesses to achieve its mission to be a relentless force of a world of longer, healthier lives. Their work has never been more important as people with cardiovascular disease face more than four times a higher rate of death than from the coronavirus. You may have even heard that doctors increasingly report that some patients develop cardiovascular complications such as heart rhythm disorders, blood clots, inflammation causing chest pain that mimics a heart attack and even cardiac arrests. The American Heart Association is advocating and supporting changes to the policies, systems, and environments that address inequities for access to education, nutrition, physical activity, and quality care, which are issues that are exacerbated by the COVID-19 pandemic. But we can't do it alone. As Susan Lucci so eloquently shared earlier in the program, our world has changed since the onset of the pandemic. Despite those changes, we remain committed to educating, empowering the women in our community, and overcoming the barriers that prevent us from living healthy and full lives. So here we are today, virtually standing together as a community, committing to ourselves, our families, and one another that we will prioritize our personal health and support the health of the women and the men who love them. Heart disease doesn't just affect the one in three. It's likely to touch every one of our lives at some point. I lost my sister, Radha, in 2018 at the age of 41. We lost a very dear friend, Susan, in June of 2020. And most recently, we lost my mother-in-law in January of this year. All had underlying conditions, but all died as a result of heart failure. That is my reason for being involved with Go Red for Women. I want to make sure each of us understands how to prevent this disease so your family doesn't suffer a loss like mine. So please take a few notes today and share what you learn with the women and men in your life. Thank you.
Jyothi, thank you for your leadership and support of the Long Island Go Red for Women campaign. Go Red is about women making a commitment to stand together and take charge of their own heart health, as well as the health of those they can't bear to live without. How many of you participated in the National Go Red Day on February 5th? Let us know right there on the chat. We want to hear from you because I have to say, Wear Red Day was an amazing day for companies to join forces and shine as leaders in the Long Island community. A special shout out to Signature Bank, who raised more than $40,000 in their efforts. So let's recap what we have learned. Heart disease is our number one killer. It does not discriminate. It affects women of all ages, races, ethnicities, and socioeconomic status. Women can have different symptoms as well. Each person's different. Some heart attack symptoms include tightness in the chest. But more often than not, you could also have extreme fatigue, pain in your neck, jaw, or back, indigestion, cold sweats, arm tingling, and nausea. Don't ignore the signs. If you think you're having a heart attack, call 911. Doing this quickly can save your life. It's still the right thing to do, even during a pandemic. Okay, now it's my pleasure to introduce our corporate honoree, Tony D'Alessio. Tony is a former board member of the AHA and is also the former managing partner of KPMG Long Island, where he spent his career. He's presently with Orbic and was recently named to serve on the board of the North Shore University Hospital. Tony has been committed to serving and working in our Long Island and New York City communities for many years and continues to be active locally and globally.
Welcome to the American Heart Association Go Red for Women digital experience. It's great to be with you today. You know, when I was asked to be the honoree for the Go Red for Women AHA event this year, it was a true honor. But my response was, I'll be the honoree, but it's my mom, Virginia, or Dolly, as she was called, D'Alessio, who is the real honoree. And I said I would accept the award or be the honoree on her behalf. We lost my mom this past April to valvular heart disease. She suffered with cardiovascular disease for many years. And today, I want to talk a little bit about her journey. But every year, I would attend the Go Red American Heart Association for Women event at the Crest Hollow Country Club. And you know, you could stand on the stage and you just look out and you see hundreds and hundreds of individuals wearing red. It was a fascinating event. And today, we're doing it on a digital basis, which is also a tremendous and awesome type of event. And you know, you look out, you stand on the stage, you see red, and red was actually my mom's favorite color. From a medical perspective, there has been tremendous advancement over the last decade with such disease with less invasive options, mostly for aortic stenosis, the TAVR approach, as you've heard, and mitral regurgitation, the mitral clip, which you probably have also read about and heard. But these less invasive options are not approved for what my mom had, a very heavily calcified mitral valve with stenosis or a constricted opening. That being said, there are numerous technologies in development, and I really have to give a shout out to Dr. Stanley Katz and Dr. Bruce Rutkin, who really educated me, my sister, my brother-in-law, who are my mom's caretakers along the journey. And our objective, working with Stan and Bruce and many others, was not to leave any stone unturned, not to leave any treatment unexplored. We wanted to give my mom the best possible life, the highest quality state of life she can get. So we knew, just as the American Heart Association educates every woman to know your numbers, to lead healthier and happier lives, we knew that with my mom's cardiovascular disease, we needed to watch her blood pressure. We needed to know her B12 count. We needed to track her hemoglobin. Thanks to pulmonary hypertension specialist Dr. Tower and his assistant Sophie, we knew those were also very key. We needed to watch her iron level, her water intake, etc. And with the success of that and what was being developed and the fact that we were blessed to have such a community and medical community that we could reach out to, my mom's condition was successfully stabilized and treated medically, but we kept praying and hoping for more developments. And you know, whenever she would go to a doctor's office, and you could speak to any of her physicians or healthcare heroes that treated her, she was always very optimistic. She was always sharp and courageous. At every office visit, she would always be smiling. She was never one to complain or lament about her problems. She was more concerned about everyone else who was around her and the fact that we had to take her to the doctor. And she was always bolstered by her faith and her boundless support that we gave her, which we wanted to give her. And whenever she would be in a doctor's office, the nurses, the physician assistants, they always wanted to hug her because they would always tell her, "Dolly, you look so great, you look so good." And her response was, "Well, that's only on the outside, it's the inside that's shot." And you know, she had such a gentle nature, very quiet, but very strong, a lot of dignity. And you could easily depict that she cared more about others than herself. You know, it would be remiss if I really did not acknowledge the many who really assisted us or supported us during the journey of my mom's cardiovascular disease. You know, a shout out to Northwell Health and the Northwell University Hospital, to Stan and Bruce, to individuals like Jeff Coovan, individuals like Ken McMillan. In addition, her primary care physician, Dr. Mark Feierstein of NYU Langone, and you know, to the Long Island leadership, to the community, the American Heart Association, Tara and Ann and Kathy Munch, former executive director, you know, being there and just asking, "How's your mother?" That meant so much. Is there anything we can do? When I look around Nassau and Suffolk County, the support from Stan and Marion Bergman of Henry Schein, Ed and Patra Vaglianti, you know, to the family of KPMG, Beth V. Meyer, and many others. The list is endless. The fact that so many people cared, so many people sent flowers, Joe Ficalora and many others, even the parish, my mom and my sister and brother-in-law's parish, St. William the Abbot, Father Joe, Father James, Father Collins, you know, being there meant so much to us. And I can't thank you enough. And, you know, I apologize if I left anyone out. But one suggestion that I want to leave you with, you know, if you ever have the task of caring for someone who has a heart disease or any type of disease, don't consider it a burden. Because what you do, my view, is what you do in life will come back to you 100 times. My mom cared for her mother, and I remember at the age of 11 when I lost my grandmother, I knew what my mother did for her mom, who also had cardiovascular disease. The advancements back then in 1969 when we lost my grandmother were nowhere we are today with the research, treatments, etc. So when you do good for others, good will come back to you. And if it's your mom that you have to take care of, consider it a blessing. So on behalf of my family, myself, I want to thank you for giving me the opportunity to be the honoree this year. However, my mom, Dolly D'Alessio, is the real honoree, as she will always be honored by my family and many others for many more years. Thank you again, and thank you for your support of the American Heart Association and the Go Red for Women. See you next year at the Crest Hollow Country Club. Have a great day.
Anthony, thank you so much for your leadership and for sharing your touching story about your mom, Dolly D'Alessio. One of the most inspiring Go Red for Women traditions is celebrating our survivors. Thank you, everyone, for sending names of loved ones and friends who have survived heart disease and stroke. It is so heartwarming to see. And we have to thank Dime Bank for sponsoring the tribute wall for us. This year, we have launched the Women of Impact campaign. It's a select group of women who are change makers in the community. Each nominee will bring together their impact team. During this 8-week campaign beginning today, March 24th through May 19th, each nominee will set a fundraising and direct mission goal to impact our Long Island community. Now we've come to a very important part of our program, and I have the honor of introducing to you today our featured Go Red for Women survivor.
My name is Linda McCabe. I was born in Brooklyn, but came home to Valley Stream when my parents bought the house in Valley Stream. So I'm 74, I'll be 75 in April, April 3rd. And I've lived here my whole life. I guess my life was pretty much average, like most women. I had three children. I was a housewife. I worked with my husband in our business. We had a few stores. And then I worked in the antique market. I was always busy. I was always had a lot of energy. I was always happy, running around, not sick a lot at all. In fact, hardly ever. It started actually very, very slowly. I was feeling fine. I thought I was feeling fine. Now, the way I feel now, I realized I wasn't feeling fine. But I thought I was feeling okay because I would just push through everything. And then I started to notice more, you know, serious things, like taking out the garbage, which wasn't a big deal because I was just rolling the cans. But when I got to the curb, I couldn't breathe. And then coming back in and having to sit down. And then I started to notice that when I went to my own home in Lynbrook, I would go up the three steps into my house. And when I got in, I'd have to sit down and catch my breath. And I really mean deep breathing. And for a few nights, I was having trouble breathing. And I was sitting up in bed halfway through the night to try to breathe. But I still thought at that point, it'll get better. But then we watched the Super Bowl, my husband and I. And he made a fire in our fireplace. And it had a good draft. But all of a sudden, I really couldn't breathe. And I had noticed that I couldn't breathe in the shower either. I was having trouble breathing in the shower. So I said to my husband, I think I need to go to the hospital. Eventually, he dropped me off at an urgent care. And I walked in, and I had to walk a ways. And when I walked in, they looked at me, and they said, we're calling an ambulance. I was happy to get into the ambulance because at that point, I really was terrified. I was just terrified. I didn't know if I was having a heart attack. I didn't know if I was going to live or die. Then I met doctors in the hospital who actually went out of their way to be nice and tell me that there were options. And I listened to them. I said, okay, do whatever you need to do. I'll take whatever medicines, whatever you tell me to do, I will do. And I did. I met Dr. Magala and I met Dr. Kanner at the same time. When they came in, and they were both standing by my bed. And they said that we think that you're a good candidate for what we want to do. And they described to me a few of the things that they'd like to do to me. One of them was the ablation. So they did the ablation the next day. And I went home. And I was still tired. But pretty soon, I got better after that. And I started to, you know, do dishes and walk around the house and going up the stairs. I didn't have to quite drag myself as much as I did, but I kept doing what I could do. I kept pushing myself. I knew I had to do that. I always pushed myself and I believed in my doctors and I kept going back and doing what I had to do. I'm very happy in my life right now. And I've been through a lot in the last 2 years, a lot of learning. What I've learned most, I guess, is that women should take better care of themselves. They need to listen to their bodies. They need to do their regular things, their mammograms and all of that. But they also need to worry about their hearts. We now are women who do more. We take care of our children. We work. We drive. We pick up people. We drive here. We do everything. We cook. We're not the grandmas of 50 years ago. We are the grandmas of today. The grandmas of today can live longer. We can live long, very good lives.
Linda, thank you so much for sharing your heart story with all of us and inspiring so many people in this time of chaos and uncertainty to focus on what they can control. So what can we control? That's a question. We can continue to support the American Heart Association, critical life-saving research that saved the life of people like Linda, and continue to fund vital education for so many within our Long Island community. And if you're able, we hope you will consider donating as well. Giving today is easy. Simply text GORedLI to 41444. Again, that's text GORedLI to 41444. In honor of Linda, today, Open Your Heart Survivor, our target is $15,000 during our Open Your Heart moment. And it's so exciting to watch your donations raise the thermometer. So let's get to 100% participation today because it's so important. It helps more cardiovascular research. It's so needed. And more answers to questions asked by survivors, and especially for the families who have lost loved ones to heart disease and stroke. It's needed everywhere. Just because we put our lives on hold for COVID-19 does not mean heart disease has stopped being our number one killer. Remember, your donation is 100% tax deductible. We hope that you will contribute a personal gift to the Go Red for Women campaign and ask that you consider becoming a Circle of Red member and make a $1,000 commitment or join our National Corvette Giving Society, which starts with a $5,000 commitment. Please know we have many Open Your Heart giving levels, and at the end of the day, we ask you to consider what amount is meaningful to you and your family. Remember, every dollar donated is an opportunity to save more women's lives. Text GORedLI to 41444 to give. It's easy, it's important, it saves lives.
Hi, everyone. My name is Ann Thorson. I am the Go Red for Women Long Island director. I'm so excited to be here today. Go Red for Women has made an extraordinary impact, but we are just beginning and we need your help. Thank you all for your generous donations. Until there's a world free from cardiovascular disease, we'll be here working to make a healthier, longer life possible for everyone. Now back to you, Tamsin.
And it's just so amazing to see the power of women in those who love them. So take a look at that thermometer continuing to rise, and we thank you for contributing today and committing to a healthier tomorrow for our daughters and for our community. We're going to come back to our thermometer in a few minutes to see what amazing impact this group has made for our mission. Thank you, everyone, for your donations, and please continue to donate. In the meantime, I'm honored to introduce the 2021 Go Red for Women Medical Honorees. They are true heroes in our Long Island community. In the midst of a pandemic, they stepped up, stepped out, and overcame so much adversity to serve their patients. Ladies and gentlemen, now representing her Mount Sinai South NASA female cardiology staff colleagues, Kathleen Sidora.
On behalf of the female cardiology team at Mount Sinai Heart, at Mount Sinai South NASA, thank you for honoring us at this 2021 virtual Go Red Luncheon. Today is an opportunity to celebrate women. In our case, the women who work hard around the clock every day to care for patients in our community and across Long Island. This year has been an incredibly challenging year for our cardiology team that consists of physicians, NPs and PAs, nurses and clerical staff, many of whom were called upon to help during the height of the pandemic, all of whom were forced to step out of their comfort zones. Staff were deployed to other areas of the hospital, worked different shifts, additional shifts, and covered our own area when it was converted into an intensive care unit. The teamwork demonstrated was extraordinary. Today, staff continue to float to other units in addition to offering extra assistance in our hospital's COVID-19 testing areas and in the vaccination pods, in addition to continuing to care for the cardiac needs of our patients. Our team is relentless. They do not back down from the many challenges presented to us during this unprecedented time. I am so proud of the way everyone stepped up and did not back down, many making personal sacrifices to help those in need. To each and every one of you, thank you. Approximately 40% of all deaths in Nassau County are attributable to some form of heart disease. For hundreds of years, women have stepped up and overcome obstacles. Today, we continue to fight to defeat the number one killer of women, cardiovascular disease. Mount Sinai South Nassau has joined the world-renowned Mount Sinai Heart Program of the Mount Sinai Hospital to become the first and only Mount Sinai Heart location on Long Island. Our new partnership with Mount Sinai Heart has allowed us to expand the services we provide, including the ability to perform more complex procedures and allowing our patients access to some of the top cardiologists and super specialists in the world, right here on the South Shore. Our partnership is essential to its mission to meet the ever-rising need for advanced procedural cardiology services on Long Island, where the impact of cardiovascular disease grows as the population ages. As women, we must work together to reduce the number of Americans who have heart attacks and strokes. As health professionals, we have a firsthand look at all the amazing work done by the American Heart Association. Their innovative research has influenced how we practice cardiology, thus allowing our patients to live longer, healthier lives. Together, Mount Sinai Heart at Mount Sinai South in Nassau and the American Heart Association make an impact on our community. We have been working together on important initiatives, including virtual community-based wellness and education events, hands-only CPR training, and opportunities for virtual speaking to raise awareness. Thank you for this heartfelt honor and opportunity. We are very grateful.
Thank you to the Mount Sinai South Nassau female cardiology staff. We're so grateful to have your tremendous efforts and care during these such difficult times. Go Red for Women is truly committed to bringing awareness to women's heart health. You can comment in the chat box what you've learned today or your key takeaway from our virtual program. And remember to share your thoughts and pictures on social media with the hashtag GoRedForWomen or hashtag GoRedLI. Thank you so much for attending. Have a great rest of the day, and please take care of yourself and take care of those you love. We will get through this. We are better together.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it, so don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. There ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. So just dance, dance, dance.
I can't stop the feeling.
So just dance, dance, dance.
Ooh, it's something magical. It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. I don't need no reason, don't be controlled. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop, stop, stop. Under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine. Nothing I can see. see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel the good, good creeping up on you, so just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. Can't stop the feeling. So just dance, dance, dance. So just dance, dance, dance. So just dance, dance, dance.
I can't stop the feeling.
So keep dancing.
Oh. Yeah. I can't stop the. I can't stop the. I can't stop the. I can't stop the.
I can't stop.
I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing.
Everybody say. Thank you.
Somebody save your soul, cause you've been sinning in the city. I know too many troubles, all these lovers got you losing control. You like a drug to me, a luxury, my sugar and gold. I want the good life every good night, you're a hot one to hold. Cause you don't even know.
Fill up my cup, Mazel Tov. Look at her dancing. Just take it off. Let's paint the town. We'll shut it down. Let's burn the roof.
And then we'll do it again.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. And do it. And do it. Let's live it up. And do it. And do it. And do it. Do it. Do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Cause I got a feeling. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling.
That tonight's gonna be a good night.
That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night. Let's live it up.
Let's live it up.
I got my money.
Hey,
let's spin it up.
Let's spin it up.
Go out and smash it.
Smash it.
Like on my god.
Like on my god.
Jump out that sofa.
Come on.
Let's kick it off. Fill up my cup.
Drink.
Mazel tov.
L'chaim.
Look at her dancing.
Move it, move
it. Just take it off. Let's paint the town.
Paint the town.
We'll shut it down.
Shut it down.
Let's burn the roof.
And then we'll do it again.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
And do it. And do it. Let's live it up. And do it. And do it. And do it. Do it. Do it.
Do it.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Here we come. Here we go. We gotta rock.
Rock. Rock. Rock.
Easy come. Easy go. Now we on top.
Top. Top. Top. Top.
Feel the shot. Body rock. Rock it. Don't stop.
Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop.
Round and round. Up and down. Around the clock.
Rock. Rock. Rock.
Rock. Monday. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Do it.
Keep, 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 keep with us. You know what we say, say. Party every day, party every day. And I'm feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be